Forex trading made easy for beginners. I'm going to give you 5 tips so that you can reduce your stress in trading and make your life as a Forex trader easier. We're going to talk about that today, coming up next. If you've been Forex trading for a long time, you know that this business is very hard. It's not as easy as clicking buy and sell. It's not just sitting around the beach the whole day and then doing nothing. You know that this is hard, but there are definitely some things that you can do to make your life easier, to make the whole entire journey more smooth and less stressful. First tip is don't geek out on the math. If you drive a car today, you don't need to know how each individual part works to be able to drive the car. For example, Bollinger Bands, you know that it's calculated by standard deviation, square root this, divide by this. By the time you're done studying that, your brain will be so tired to study how Bollinger Band really works, how to use it, when to use it. I know in the past tutorials, I've talked about how is Bollinger Bands calculated, how is RSI calculated, how is MACD calculated. I'm just doing that to serve the maths geeks. If you want to make your life easier, just skip all that. Just know how to use it, when to use it, which time frame to use it on, which currency pair to use it on. That's it. Knowing the calculation behind it is just a bonus. At the end of the day, everything is calculated for you. You don't need to do it manually. You just need to key in the settings. That's it. Second tip is to narrow down your focus. Now, there are 2 things that you can narrow down on. The first one is focus on predictable pairs. In other words, trade the more popular pairs, the more liquid pairs, the pairs that has a good amount of volume. Because the higher the liquidity, the higher is the predictability of that currency pair. For example, the major pairs, euro, dollar, dollar, yen, especially currency pairs with dollar in it, then focus on those, especially as a beginner, focus on the less volatile pairs. Because the less volatile it is, the easier it is to trade as a beginner. Then the second thing you need to focus on is not only the predictable pairs, but the cheap pairs. Still comes down to one thing, which are currency pairs with high liquidity. Because the higher the liquidity, the cheaper would be the cost of trading, the lower would be your spread. You pay less money to your broker. When you pay less money to your broker, you make yourself richer, you know what I'm saying? Better yet, focus on both predictable and cheap pairs. A good currency pair to start with, euro dollar or dollar yen. Another thing you need to take note of is don't trade way too many currency pairs on day one. The mistake a lot of traders make is that on day one, they go and trade all the major pairs, all the minor pairs, and maybe some exotic pairs. Like if you trade 20 pairs on day one, and each pair, you open 3 time frames. So 20 times 3 is like 60 screens you need to monitor. If you have 60 screens on your desk, all I can say is you're the champion, okay? I've seen traders who only trade 2 to 3 pairs and they can just live based on that. I've seen traders who trade with one pair, just one pair, and they can just live on that. The only time I look at exotic pairs, for example, this morning, I went to the currency changer because I need to travel. Then I look at those exotic pairs. I don't trade it because of the spread. The key to predictability is also trade countries in which the political economic situation is very stable. Tip number 3, have less than 10 indicators for each trading system. In fact, I think 10 indicators is a bit too many. The purpose of having an indicator is to give you more confidence, is to give you confirmation. So if that indicator is right there and then all it does is freaking confuse you, then please do me a favor, just remove it. Just remove it. That stupid indicator is just there, taking up space in your chart. That is the function of it. So a lot of beginner traders, they use indicators as a crutch to give them a false sense of confidence, when all it does is just suck your money away and make you more confused. Other traders, they improve every day, you get more and more confused every day. Stop being an indicator hoarder. Do a major spring cleaning. You'll feel that a major burden has been lifted off of you. It's like freedom. So how do you know whether you should remove an indicator or not? You backtest it, forward test it. If so far, it does nothing but give you losses, throw it away. Make your life easier. Now here's the thing, I've seen some traders who have zero indicators on their chart. Maybe they have just one moving average and that's all they need because they trade based on price action. In fact, go to trading floors. Traders just rely on the market sentiment. Like if they see that people on the floor are buying, then they're gonna trade based on that or against that. There are people who just trade, make investment just based on the tape, reading the tape. Tip number four, you've got to outsource. Outsource your trading. Meaning at the end of the day, you don't need to click buy and sell yourself. You don't need to research the market yourself every single day. In other words, you are using OPT, other people's time. Robert Kiyosaki said that the key to riches is use OPM, other people's money, and OPT, other people's time. So there are four main ways that you can outsource your trading. The first one is by using signals. If you engage a signal provider, all that signal provider need to do is maybe send you a WhatsApp message, Telegram message, buy here, TP here, cut loss here. And all you need to do is just follow. But if you're in the toilet, you miss that WhatsApp message, then you miss the trade. The second way to outsource is, this is quite similar to signals, and that is copy trading. The thing about signals is that you need to manually get into the trade and you need to see the message on time. The thing about copy trading is that you just need to spend time picking the right people to copy. Then from that point onwards, if you decide to copy that person, whenever the trader press buy and sell, everything is done automatically inside your account. The downside of this is that if that person that you copy goes in a trade that you don't like, your trade still gets executed automatically. So there are pros and cons of signals and copy trading. If you want me to do a video on these two things, let me know that in the comment section below. The third way that you can outsource your trading is through using EA or robot. Again, you need to spend time programming a robot. You need to spend time hiring a good programmer who wouldn't mess up for you. And also you need to spend time updating the robot when market conditions change. So it doesn't mean that if you have a robot, then it's like, I'm done. You still need to put in the work once in a while. Then the fourth way of outsourcing is, this is why the hedge fund industry exists, having an account manager to trade for you. So for hedge funds, they need a minimum capital. For example, $1 million, $5 million, depending on the hedge fund. Again, with account managers, you still need to pick good account managers to manage the fund for you. All of these four things, you still need to put in the work, you still need to put in the research to pick the right single provider, trader to copy, to pick the right robot, to pick the right account manager. Again, if you want me to do videos on how to pick good ones, let me know down in the comment section below. And some people ask me, Karen, do you provide signals? For now, I don't. Maybe it'll change in the future, but for now, I just prefer you learn how to fish than me giving you a fish every single day. Now the thing is, for these small things, there are good and bad providers. You just need to learn how to pick the right ones and avoid the bad ones. And one mistake that a lot of traders make when they pick all these things is they just focus on returns, when you should be focusing on risk-adjusted returns. If you come from the finance industry, you know that nobody focuses on returns. Tip number five is to get a mentor. Now, having a mentor really helped me a lot because my mentor will tell me, just focus on this, these few indicators, then the rest just ignore. Totally shortcut my journey a lot because then I don't need to go to Google and then look at website after website after website to find out what works, what doesn't work. And to find out what works and what doesn't work, you need to back test, forward test. So that's a whole chunk of time gone. And not only that, you need to make a lot of mistakes yourself. And that's another whole chunk of time gone. I know there are people who watch one video of mine, two videos of mine, then they make one assumption. Oh, anybody can just read books and then vomit out everything. Like, do you know how to do your research? To my supporters and fans, don't learn from haters because their stupidity is so contagious. I wish I can just read some books, look at some website article, and then become a successful trader overnight. I wish those haters are right. Now, reading books, I'm not to say is totally useless. Reading books help to give you ideas, to reinforce what you have learned from your mentor. But it's not the most effective way to learn how to trade. Your mentor doesn't have to be me, it can be somebody else. Just find one that really believes in you. Just find one that is committed to help you succeed. Why doesn't reading books work? It's because the way our human brain learns things, one of the least effective ways is through reading. Ironically, a lot of the schools nowadays, they are still in Stone Age. Read, study, exam. The best way to learn something is to teach other people. If you can't teach other people, then you need to get your hands dirty. Meaning, practice doing it. Okay, practice doing it. I know my handwriting is like, you get my point? The way my mentors taught me is, on day one, straight away to the platform. My mentor never taught me, go and read this book, study this book. It's day one, Bloomberg Terminal, day one. Buy here, TP here, cut loss here. Then if you want to learn more things, you want to increase your confidence in your knowledge, then go and read books. When you're bored, when you have nothing to do, then go and read books. When there's no trade for today, then go and read books. So this also means that don't pick a mentor that is way too textbooky, if that's even a word. Okay, so with that, let me know down in the comment section below, which tip are you implementing right now? Okay, so with that, I'll talk to you in the next episode. Bye.